Hey guys, Bill Competition Cars. So now we're going to go over the engine bay, interior, and trunk of this 1978 Diamond Jubilee Thunderbird. I almost said Mark V, because I've had several of the Diamond Jubilees. You don't, when you think Diamond Jubilee, you think Lincoln. So I think it's super cool that this car, that Ford made this car. It has a 351 V8 engine, not the smaller 302. Very nice, very tidy original engine bay. It's a 25,000 mile car. Looks to have the original hood mat as well. Everything on this car confirms mileage. Get a little shot of the tag here. You can see in there. We got, when this thing goes on bring a trailer, there you go. When it goes on bring a trailer, we'll have a close up of that. So engine bay looks nice. Looks exactly like you'd expect an original unmolested car to look like. Okay. Coming around to the interior. I see so much Lincoln Mark V in this car, it's just crazy. And, oh, I know I was gonna tell you guys. So, I've had three Thunderbirds, 77 through 79 T-Birds that I've run on Bring a Trailer. And mine are the top three highest selling cars. I'm excited about this car because it is a Diamond Jubilee, it does have low miles, and you just don't see these. And this is a very well loaded car. A lot of the ones I had didn't have power windows or didn't have power seats or, you know, kind of a more of a base model type car. This thing is tricked out with everything. When we get to the driver's side, I'll show you the gauge package. It has a factory tach. Back seats, again, looks like they haven't even been touched or sat in. There's no fading. A lot of times on these type of cars, you'll see a lot of sun fade. I mean, look at the seats. Very thick, full plush, correct color. Under the mats, the carpet is absolutely brand new. Shoot up under the doors. You guys know I don't do rusty cars, so the bottom, that bottom of that door jamb is nice and fresh and pristine. Vinyl top looks like $1 million. And look at the detail in the trunk. All this is carpeted, again, just like the Mark V Diamond Jubilees. And it seems to me this car was bought new by let's see here, Carol Satter bought this car new, and it looked like to me she owned it up until 2000. I think this is the most, these are a bunch of registration cards. There was a date. Looks like she owned it through till 2000, October of 2000, and then sold it to somebody else. And then the guy that I got it from the second owner. Some documentation back here. This is kind of cool. Little metal Diamond Jubilee. Little sign to hang up. Let me show you guys this here. Owner's manuals, warranty booklet, odometer disclosure when it was sold new. And she bought this in February of 78. So she got it early 78. There's the original spare. It's a Firestone, I believe that is, 721. But look at all the rubber molding. Everything is just really pristine on this car. Haven't found anything that doesn't work. This is cool. I got an extra set of keys to it too, but this has the key that has the matching wood grain that you see on the trim and the steering wheel and dash. Can you see that? That's pretty cool. And I got one of my YouTube guys just rides my butt about this. When you open and close these doors, listen to this. It's a little, he calls it the clackety clack. So I finally, I got to install it yet, but I finally got the little bushings that you install here, which I will do. I guess you take this striker off, unscrew it, and put that in there, and it keeps it nice and tight. That's a very common issue. But look at the interior on this side. No wear, no tear. Get a shot of that dash cluster with the tach, which I think is super cool. I mean, a Thunderbird with a factory tach, that, again, is just so cool to me. So as you can see, I am excited about this car. It is a special car in very nice, pristine condition. Vogue tires. You might like them, you might not like them. They're in great shape. I think they look fine on the car. Tires are not terribly expensive. A standard white wall, I can get them for between $400 and $500. But I think the Vogues look okay. I was almost on the fence. Then once I got the car and cleaned it up, I'm like, you know what? That's pretty good. So that's something that we'll leave be. We're not gonna do anything with that. Again, car has been paint corrected. We're gonna try to get this, it's Friday, so I'm a little bit busy today. I'm gonna try to get this car up on the lift and get some undercarriage footage. But as you can imagine, the undercarriage looks as great as the engine bay. So check it out. This will be for sale on Bring a Trailer. You're going to see it first on YouTube. If you have any questions, put them in the comment section. I'll answer them as quickly as possible. I always stay very engaged. And we appreciate you guys taking a look. Have a good day.